What comes to your mind when I talk about moving pictures? Shows, movies, videos, or maybe online series? But what if I tell you that the concept of filmmaking has its own history, which has evolved with time and technology? Many of us are familiar with the fact that the very first feature film in the Indian subcontinent was Raja Harish Chandra. But the story behind this legendary film is equally worth listening to. The idea of filmmaking came into the world in late 19th century. But the idea of full feature Indian film came into the mind of the legend on 15th of April 1911. And this legend was none other than the great Dada Saheb Phalke. Generally, the artists get inspired by others' piece of art and then they try to create their own artwork by their own imagination and idea. And a similar thing happened with Phalke also. On 14th of April 1911, Dada Saheb Phalke with his elder son Bal Chandra went to see a film titled Amazing Animals at the America Indian Picture Palace, Girgaon. Surprised at seeing animals on the screen, Phalke took his family to see the film the next day. As it was Easter, the theater screened a film about Jesus, The Life of Christ, 1906, directed by the French director Elise Guy Blaché. While watching Jesus on the screen, Phalke envisioned Hindu deities like Rama and Krishna. Instead, and decided to start in the business of moving pictures. After completing his two-week trip to London to learn filmmaking techniques, he founded Phalke Films Company on 1st of April 1912. During Phalke's trip to London, he placed an order for a Williamson camera, a Kodak RAW film, and a perforator, which reached Bombay, now Mumbai, in May 1912. He set up a processing room and taught his family to perforate and develop the film. Though Phalke was certain of his ideas of filmmaking, he could not find any investors. So he decided to make a short film to demonstrate the techniques. What interesting thing Phalke did was that he planted few peas in a pot and placed the camera in front of it and shot one frame a day for over a month. This resulted in a film lasting just over a minute of a seed growing, sprouting and changing into a climber. Phalke titled this short film Ankurachi Vad, that is, growth of a pea plant, and showed it to selected individuals. Some of them including Yashwant Rao Nandakarni and Narayan Rao Devare offered a loan to Phalke. And from here, the journey of India's first feature film began. To shortlist the story, Phalke considered various depicted stories in Hindu mythology. Even Phalke's family shortlisted few legends of Krishna, Savitri and Satyavan, and Harish Chandra. At the time, a play based on the legends of Harish Chandra was popular on Marathi and Urdu stages. Friends and neighbors had often called Phalke Harish Chandra for having sold all his belongings, except his wife's Mangal Sutra, to fulfill his filmmaking dream. So Phalke decided on the legends of Harish Chandra and wrote the script for his feature film. The plot of the film was simple as well as interesting, where King Harish Chandra, played by D.D. Dabke, was shown teaching his son, Rohitashwa, played by Balachandra Phalke, how to shoot with a bow and arrow in the presence of Queen Taramati, played by Anna Salunkhe. The casting was a big challenge in those times. Phalke published advertisements in various newspapers like Indu Prakash, calling for the cast and crew required for the film. It was well received and huge number of applicants came in for the auditions. But Phalke was not satisfied with the performer's skill. He discontinued the advertisement and started scouting the artist through theatre companies. Padu Rang Gadadhar Sane and Gajanan Vasudeva Sane were amongst the first artists to join Phalke Film Company. Both of them
join at the salary of rupees 40 per month.
Gajanan Sane introduced his acquaintance Dattatre Damodar Dabke. Phalke was impressed with his physique and personality and offered him the lead role of Harishchandra.
But the search was still not over. Phalke was still searching for a female character for his film. Because all the women, those who had auditioned, he was not satisfied with their acting skills. On the other hand, acting in films those days was considered to be a big taboo.
One day, while having tea at a restaurant
on Grant Road, Phalke noticed Krishna Hari, popularly known as Anna Salunkhe, a young, effeminate man with slender features and ham. Salunkhe was working as a cook and a waiter at a restaurant at the monthly salary of Rs. 10. He agreed to work in Phalke's film when he offered him a raise of Rs. 5.
Phalke auditioned many for the role of Rohit Ashwa, the son of Harishchandra and Taramati. But none of the parents would allow their children to work in the film.
Finally, Phalke's elder son, Balachandra, was assigned with the role. And by this, he became the first child artist in Indian cinema. During the process of pre-production, Phalke hired around 40 people and advised every artisan that they must tell everyone that they were working in a factory for a man named Harishchandra. Because working in a film those days was a big taboo.
He watched several foreign films to learn about screenplay writing and then completed the script of Raja Harishchandra. The film had an all-male cast as no women were available to play female leads.
At this time, Phalke met Rajpurkar Natak Mandali Drama Company's prop writer Babaji Rao Rane. Phalke shared his idea of indigenous film production with Rane. Rane was impressed and soon lent his support by giving him his artists and costumes. After this, the set for erected indoor shooting was prepared. A painter, Ranganekar, was hired for the salary of 60 per month.
Phalke imported the hardware required for the filmmaking and exhibition from England, France, Germany and the United States. From manufacturers including Houghton Butchers, Zee's Teasers and Pathé. This included negative and positive film stocks, cameras, lights, film laboratory equipment, printing and editing machines, negative cutting tools and film projectors.
He decided to take the responsibility of the makeup, direction, film editing, film processing and production design.
He asked Trimbak B. Telang, his childhood friend from Nasik, who was working as a priest at the Triambakeshwar Shiva temple. Phalke had taught him still photography as a childhood hobby. After his arrival, Phalke trained Telang in the operation of the Williamson camera and made him the film's cinematographer.
It was the time when Dada Sahab decided to begin filming. The production design of the film began after the monsoon of 1912.
Some of the male actors playing female roles, including Anna Salunkhe, who was playing the female lead, were not ready to shave off their mustaches because it is a part of the Hindu rituals to be performed after the death of one's father.
Phalke persuaded the actors and their fathers to have their mustaches shaved and the unit led for one gani. During the days when the whole crew was trying to give their 100%, an incident happened which shocked the entire crew.
While playing with other children, Balachandra fell on a rock and his head started bleeding. The scene that was to be filmed showed Rohit Ashwa, Balachandra's character, dead on a funeral pyre. Phalke and the whole crew was aware that if they paused this at this stage, the whole team might lose their algorithm, also resuming the outdoor shoot after Balachandra's recovery and would have delayed the production and incurred costs.
To avoid such situation, Phalke stoically decided to shoot the scene with unconscious Balachandra. Dada Sahab was so passionate about the perfect scenes that he reshooted certain scenes the very next day because the previous day's scenes were not up to the desired quality. The complete shooting took place in 6 months and 27 days to produce a film of 3,700 feet, that is 1,100 meter, a full 4 reel. And now was the time for the film's premiere.
Phalke had difficulties in arranging a theater for screening, as criticism for his work had already started. He decided to show the film to a selected audience and arranged for a premiere at the Olympia Theatre, Bombay, on 21st of April 1913 at 9 p.m.
After seeing the film, Justice Donald noted that the film would help Europeans to learn about Hindu mythology.
Anant Narayan Nolgekar of Kesari in his review mentioned that Phalke had grandly brought his skills to the notice of the world. The Times of India, in their review, noted the scenes depicted in the film are simply marvelous, and it is really a pleasure to see their piece of Indian workmanship. With the favorable reviews generated, Nana Saheb Chitre, manager of the Coronation Cinematograph and Variety Hall Girgaon, expressed his desire to screen the film.
The film had its theatrical release on 13th of May 1913. At Coronation Cinematograph and Variety Hall.
The show's duration was 1.5 hours for 4 shows scheduled a day at 6 p.m., 8 p.m., 10 p.m. and 11:45 p.m. An advertisement for the film published in the Bombay Chronicles, which had a note added at the end that the ticket rates would be double the usual rates.
The film earned pretty well and was released in various places such as Maharashtra, Gujarat, London and Colombo.
Some interesting facts about the film. The film being silent had English, Marathi and Hindi language intertitles. Dadasaheb Phalke spent his savings to make the film. The film was made by entirely Indian cast and crew. In 1917, the film's last print caught fire due to an accident. Phalke readily reshot the film titled Satyavadi Raja Harishchandra to produce the version that exists today. The film is partially lost. Only the first part and the last reel of the film are preserved at the National Film Archive of India. Although some historians believe these reels belong to a 1917 remake of the film by Phalke titled Satyavadi Raja Harishchandra. The debate about Raja Harishchandra as the first full-length Indian feature film began when some historians considered Dada Saheb Thorne's silent film Shri Pundalik, released on 18th May 1912, as made an Indian film. However, Shri Pundalik was a recording of a play with a fixed camera and the film's production was done in London. Plus, it had a British camera person. This certainly takes away the Indian tag from Shri Pundalik. This is the reason the government of India recognizes Raja Harishchandra as the first Indian feature film. In 1969, it introduced Dada Saheb Phalke Award, the country's highest award in cinema, to commemorate Phalke's contribution in Indian cinema. Film historian Firoz Rangoonwala feels that the commercial success of this film laid the foundation for the film industry in our country.
If you found this video interesting, please like and subscribe. Also, do not forget to share it with your friends, family and colleagues. You can also let us know in the comment section what all topics interest you and you want us to make further videos on. See you until next. Jai Hind.